actually there is a error in that 6BFN file. So what I have done is I need to check the replacement for that file, that 6BFN similar file. I need to download it and I need to do the entire process again, that is finding the binding site, finding the ligand, everything will change. But as of now, I'm changing your target, that is 4NTJ for learning purpose. I'm changing this. Your ligand will remain the same, but you need to repeat the entire process. Now, after this, what you need to do is, as I told, Autodoc, right click Autodoc, make macromolecule. You are making, this is your second preparation. You can see your blue color hydrogen atoms are added and your Coleman charges are also added. So this is the second preparation for your protein target. Next, click on your Vina wizard. Then you need to go to OpenBabel. Directly click on OpenBabel. This is an inbuilt software in your Pyrex. Okay. Here, insert new item. Desktop docking. Yeah, so this entirely will change. Don't get confused. Okay, ligand I am taking, considering it as same, camphorol open. So this can open SDF in SDF format. Again, click on this quercetin. You can dock individually your ligand with your protein, or your multiple ligand with your target also you can do. Next, this is very important. This is your formula. This is your title number. Right click. Then you need to do minimize all. What does it mean? Minimize all means you are minimizing the energy of your docking ligand with your protein. So this is your E362.50. It will be in your kilojoule mole. Okay. Next, what you need to do is, before that, when you have done this make Autodoc, make macromolecule, your hydrogen bond were added. When you go to your Autodoc, you can see your, this was your previous thing. I'll delete this or you'll get confused. I'll delete this. When you do your macromolecule, make macromolecule, you can see your PDBQT file. What is PDBQT? PDBQT file is the file where your second preparation has been done. Hydrogen bond is added, Coleman charges are added, gastrin charges are added, different charges are added in order to prepare your protein. Okay, then again go to macromolecule, OpenBabel. Okay, again come to OpenBabel. Now again you need to convert this ligand into PDBQT similar to your macromolecule. So right click, convert all to Autodoc ligand PDBQT. Done. It will take few seconds. Done. Similarly, when you click on ligand, you have PDBQT file. Now go to your Vina hazard, then click on start. Here it is asking no ligand selected. You need to press your shift and together you can select. Then here to select your left. Next, forward. Now this is a very, very important step, that is selection of your grid box. In order to select your grid box, earlier what we have done, we have taken your binding sites. That 6 binding sites we have taken, that was your LEU291TYR288, that was your protein which was not correct, that file got correct. So for 4NTJ, I have already taken your binding site, means taken your binding site in your discovery studio. Okay, so what I'll do is, here for this binding site is different, don't get confused. Here I have tyrosine 105. So first go to tyrosine 105, so it will be numbered properly. Here you have tyrosine 105, right click, display label atom. Why you are doing this, I'll let you know. Next, I have written valine 102. I have 102, I have noted down. So right click, display label atom. Almost for everything, take nearly 6 things. Okay, 6 to 7 amino acids site you can take. Next, I have serine 156. Scroll down. This number wise you can label atom. Next is, I'll take a huge number, valine 279. It's the last amino acid, not last, but it's 279. Valine display label atom 279. Next is lysine 280. After this, you need to enlarge this. Now you can scroll this, okay? You can actually scroll this. So this is a grid parameter. This you need to take it here. You need to select your grid based on your binding site for your new ligand, okay? Zoom it. You need to do like this. What you need to do is this labeled atom you need to cover entirely in this box. Whatever you want to do, you can do it. Do it in the sense, enlarge this, do this. So whether it is completely covered or not, whatever you are mentioning, whether it is completely covered or not. Done. Click on escape. Then see here you have center X, Y, Z being adjusted. Okay, so X is 18 point something, Y, Z in 3 dimensions you are doing. After this, directly go and click on your forward. Before that, what is exhaustiveness? Exhaustiveness is nothing but my system has 8 CPU, so it will work on 8 CPU. So it will be faster, don't change anything. So it will work on run Vina. Then just click on forward. Now your program will be running. So it will take, depending on your protein and ligand size, it will take time. Okay, so I don't think this will take much time. Within minutes it will happen. So we'll wait for this. And we'll analyze the output also. Output 2 we'll analyze. So one is done. So you can see here the status. One is finished. For a second it is running. And of course you need to have a good internet speed too. Actually, this is offline. Sorry, for this, you don't need any internet connection. It depends on your CPU. I think this is also running. I think this will be finished right now. Docking is done. So like this screen, you can see, and here you can scroll and see your docked ligand with your protein. Now you have different parameters here. You have binding affinity, which is very important. You have mode, RMSD, root mean square deviation. What does it signify? Always you need to, so these are the different poses of your same ligand, okay? So minus 8, you need to always see your RMSD, both should be 0. RMSD will tell you the distance, the maximum distance between your docked ligand and the protein. It should be always 0. And the highest negative value will tell you the perfect docked ligand. So lesser the negative value, so your binding affinity will be higher. Okay, so here in this case it is minus 8.5. so based on your 5280343, I think it is camphorol, so it is binding affinity is minus 8.5. similarly, you need to look for 00. Your 00 again means it is 863. I think this is for aquacetin, minus 8.3 it is. So you need to note down your binding affinity. So this is your result. So by this you can conclude. I'm not sure whether 343 is camphorol or whatever. So you can tell your 343 number, your binding affinity is higher than your minus 8.3. So like this you can conclude your binding affinity. If you want to analyze your docking interactions, so I'll let you in a new video. Before that, I want to just show you the output of this. For that, you need to go to your MGL tools. You need to locate where your Pyrex is at. MGL tools, my Pyrex, and that ligand and macromolecule which you have saved. Macromolecule, 4NTJ prep. So here you have 4NTJ prep, and here I have my output. This is very important. See, here you can see your remark Vina result, minus 8.5, and different parameters are also there. 4NTJ prep. This is for second one. So in order to analyze the interaction, I'll tell you in a new video using Discovery Studio. Hope you like this video. And one more thing which I have forgotten is this thing. Your, for example, if you don't have your native ligand itself with your protein, then what you need to do? For example, if your protein is completely new or new isolation which you are doing, then in order to identify the binding site, like we have chosen amino acids using your Discovery Studio, then we have made this grid box. In that case, you need to completely cover this grid box. No need of specific selection. You can completely select this grid box and you can proceed with that. Okay, you should not have any confusion. Hope you like this video.